My name is Adam Clegg. I'm a level designer at SOE Live, and we're here in Las Vegas at Bally's.
All right, Adam, so your beta has been full in launch. You've been getting a lot of feedback. What kind of stuff have you been doing to change the levels based on that feedback?
Well, we've gotten a lot of beta feedback on the level design, base design, capture mechanics, just everything, really. Higby preaches that you need a 1,000 or 2,000 players in a beta like PlanetSide 2 in order to test your levels. So everything that we made was kind of level design theory, right? And there wasn't a lot of games to go on except for PlanetSide 1 on a game of this scale. So now that people are in the beta and they're playing it, we've gotten tons of feedback. We've changed capture mechanics almost across the board on all three of our facilities, as well as outposts. A recent update is we're placing a lot of barricades in front of spawn rooms because there's a lot of tank spam hitting the spawn rooms. And, you know, little things like that. And just across the board, we've been making changes. If you've been in the beta, you've known the changes that we've made to our level design and the systems around it.
Now, there's a lot of players out there who may be a little bit familiar with level design, such as like choke points and spawn zones and stuff like that. How are you handling certain things like choke points and funneling the players into a certain firefight while you're there?
Well, we do that a lot with the adjacency, with how we have the outposts laid out. So with Esomir, we knew to spread them out a little more because we wanted to have more defined lines of attack to the next outpost. With Indar, it was a little harder because there was a lot of outposts. You didn't know if somebody was just going to go like this, right? Or like, we're going to go around here. With Esomir, you know kind of where they're coming from. I think we did that as far as a large scale. As far as like smaller scale choke points, I think we've done a lot of changes there too, just in our facility layouts. We've move some props, you know, moving props around, changing outposts, redesigning them, definitely creating a lot more choke points. Actually, on Amerish, which is our third continent, we are purposely creating choke points at forward spawning outposts to a facility. So, for example, on Indar, if you want to get to a facility with your tank armada, you can just roll right past a forward spawn, and if there's guys there or not, you can just be like, okay, see you later, I'm going right to the facility. On Amerish, we're making sure that you fight at that forward spawn before you get to go and take the facility. So there's tons of choke points that we're adding.
Now, one of the biggest concerns that I think for you would be, since you've got people who are on the ground in vehicles that can fly and traverse terrain, some can even float, and some even infantry that can fly, how does that come into the level design so you make sure that everyone has an equal opportunity to get in certain places, or just overall just balancing the map?
Well, you bring up a good point. With aircraft, it's a lot harder because we can't just put a roof over everything. We have a lot of weapons and weapon systems that are anti-aircraft. We have a lot of rocket launchers and anti-air turrets that help us a lot with aircraft. With ground troops and tanks, we have more control over where a tank can go and where a troop can go. So we kind of focus on that the most. And then we go over after it's done and look, how good is our air cover? Does this outpost need to have air cover? Is it going to be, you know, sometimes the right decision is to make sure air can take out this outpost. Sometimes it's not. So I think we kind of supplement the cover with our weapon systems and just how we decide how each outpost should fight.
And I heard a funny story with some poles you've had to add to the lands recently because people have been exploiting how the vehicles work in levels.
Yeah, there are certain cases, like especially in the worst case was at the warp gate, which is where all your friendly friends are. You know, it's your empire. It's where you kind of like gather and then go out. But people were griefing by taking tanks and sunderers and driving them into where the players are and running people over. So we kind of had to make fence posts and place them around the areas just to block your own empire's tanks because people were griefing. But we've done that at other places too. I think we've done it a little bit at some of the larger outposts and just really high traffic areas that we know where there's going to be a lot of vehicles. And with this game, with any online PvP game, you have to worry about the enemy and the friends because there are griefers out there. So.
And what's the hardest thing about getting fan feedback to make the level more playable for your fan base or their data, I guess it's easy.
I think it's hard when there's not enough detail in the feedback. A lot of the feedback is very across the board, like, this base design is terrible, or I don't like the fight here. And while we like that feedback, we want more detail. Like, I don't like the fight here because this, 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 this. And a lot of people do that. I'm not saying people don't do it. A lot of people do that. So that's the kind of feedback we really enjoy, because it's something that we can go into the game right away, place the objects that they're talking about, and then see how it works out. And that's the kind of feedback that helps us the best, I would say.
Awesome, man. And if people are interested in getting a beta key, where can they get a beta key at?
You can always ask me on Twitter. I'm at AR Klegger. You can ask the official PlantSide Twitter, at PlantSide2. And we also have our Alpha Squad that's going to go up until a little bit before launch, which is a $40 value. We basically pay $40, get $40 in our station cash, and we give you a bunch more things, including beta keys. So yeah, follow our Twitters, ask us, and we should help hook you up.